Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at how you can manage the Power BI Pro trial with inside of your tenant. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Pro trial. I've talk to a bunch of customers, and sometimes those customers, they don't want the pro trial to just be enabled for Power BI. Before we get into that, let me just talk about the two different ways real quick that you can actually get and use a pro trial. The first way is inside of Office 365. So it's just like a regular license block. You can assign those licenses out. It's a pack of 25 and it lasts for 30 days. You can extend it once. The more typical trial that gets used is the in-service Try Power BI Pro for 60 days. So this is a 60-day free pro trial. It's an individual-based opt-in trial. All right, enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and actually see what this looks like. All right, I'm inside of Power BI. To see if you're a free or a pro user, you can just go up to the little person icon up in the upper right, and you can actually see free account. And here it says buy pro now because I'm a free user. I don't have a pro license assigned to my account. I can go and try and purchase something. Outside of doing that, typically what people will run into is if they're a free user, they'll say, oh, this workspace thing. Let me go ahead and create a workspace. And then we get this lovely invitation to upgrade to Power BI Pro. It's so nice. This is the default experience. So if you don't have a pro license, if you're just a free user, you'll get this dialogue and it'll say upgrade to Power BI Pro and give you three options. One, you can buy now, you can try free, or you can say not now. The try free will give you that 60-day pro trial. So if I go ahead and say try free, it'll say, hey, Power BI is yours for 60 days. You get all the Power BI Pro features. Awesome, got it. It refreshes a little bit. And then in the upper right, you'll see Pro Trial, 59 days left. Now I am a Pro Trial user. If we go back up to the person, you'll actually see Pro Account Trial. Had you actually clicked on this, it would have given you the same dialogue. That's awesome. However, there are organizations where their mindset is, look, we wanna have a little more control over this. We don't just want people signing up for the pro trial. So what can we do? There are a couple options that you have now. So if we go back over to my login where I am actually the tenant admin, I can go up to the gear and go to admin portal, and then we can go to tenant settings. And there's a couple options here. So first off, originally we had nothing. Then what came along was this publish get help information, which would give you options to enter some URLs that can be helpful to you. At that time, when this was introduced, the licensing request URL would actually trigger the disablement of pro trials. Since that time though, another option has come about, which is allow users to try Power BI Pro. This is enabled by default. And so what you can do is come in and say, disable this, and this will turn off the pro trial opt-in for individual users. This can get a little confusing and the dialogues can change a little bit. So what I wanna do is walk you through what both of these are gonna do. Originally I said that the get help option would disable that pro trial, but now what's happened is the disablement of the pro trial has been decoupled from the get help. So they're now two independent things. So let's start off with the get help and see what that does. And then we'll enable the disablement of pro trial. Yeah, that's right, right? Enable, disable. Yeah, we're gonna enable the disablement. All right, back to my computer. I've got a couple different tenants where this was already set up because it can lag a little bit. So it says it could take up to 15 minutes. So I've already pre-set up some tenants, but the first thing I'm gonna show you is where I've entered a licensing request. And all I did was add in the URL to our webpage. And then I hit apply, right? So not anything spectacular, but the idea here is that I want any licensing requests, I want an option to go off. And if we remember when we had this, you'll see buy pro now. Remember that, the buy pro now. And when we got the dialogue, it had buy now, try free, or not now, right? So the buy now is the thing I want you to focus in on. All right, so let's go over to a tenant where what I've got is just the URL configured. So let's go do the workspace thing again. And our dialogue has changed a little bit. So now instead of buy now, it says upgrade account. Ooh, that's different. And if we go look at the dialogue up top, now you will see upgrade account instead of buy now. So what happens if I click on upgrade account? So if we go to create workspace and we say upgrade account, takes me to the URL that we supplied in the get help. And this can be a web page in your organization that just explains the process for getting that pro trial. So you could have even a signup form. Maybe it's tied into a Power app, maybe a SharePoint workflow or something of that nature where it'll put them through a flow to get that pro license assigned to them. I've seen that done in a lot of organizations. So this allows you to direct people to that site, which is very cool. Let's go to my other account. So this one has the URL. In addition, it also has allow users to try Power BI Pro disabled. So now it's got both. So let's see what that experience looks like. So if we go here, we'll go to workspace, we'll go to create workspace. And now all we see is upgrade account. We don't see try free. We don't see buy now. All we see is upgrade account. That's bananas, right? Like that's allows you to force them into that flow if they want Power BI Pro. So they can't do the 60-day pro trial opt-in. They also don't have the buy now option, which means they have to hit upgrade account, which will take them to your organization page internally. Maybe it's a SharePoint site, whatever, that walks them through that flow of how to get a pro license and or to educate. Maybe you've got premium in your environment and say, look, you don't necessarily need a pro license to do and access all of these things. And just to confirm here, so if we go up to the top here, we'll see upgrade account as well. If we select this, that also takes us to the URL that was entered. Bam, that's perfect. So if you're looking to manage this for your organization, you now have some tools at your disposal to allow you to control that experience a little better than what was there originally when Power BI first launched. So this is very cool. It's giving power to the admins and the organizations to control that experience a little bit more and allow folks to get through the right processes that are defined inside of your organization. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Is this something that you're going to use? Have you played around with this? Is it implemented in your organization? I want to know. Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.